Why does he get a desk? I know, right? I should pull up a seat next to him.
They're public servants, you know?
Like you. You got a desk too.
With a computer and a telephone.
You know, I think we got a nice locked room we can put him in.
We got a couple. Vault. Whatever happens if that door closes? Do we call the locksmith? What do they do? Because it's built in. I mean, they painted over the vault door. If you take a look at it, they painted over it.
I don't know. Hi there.
Hi. Oh, we're going to be deputy, okay. Deputy, this goes to you, I guess.
Yeah, I thought it was.
Okay.
Oh, my God. Talking about the guy?
Yeah. And what can I give you this? I'm sorry. Nora.
Yes. Oh, you talk to me?
Sorry, I'm sorry. I called you. Another lady that we say you look like when we first started.
Emma? You know, last year, the stocking?
Okay.
It was Emma Old Sergeant.
They just gave it to you, but...
They put my name on the other side.
Oh.
I'm so cute.
Can you turn your hair curly?
My hair curly, yeah. And the black.
Now I'm gonna show you, you know. I can prefer, that's all.
I surprised I mean, because I kind of have one.
What's the name? Surprised it was.
Because she didn't work anything, I was like, you can talk.
Want to reserve your hands, please?
Nope, he's gonna turn on. Or two.
Is this your first case?
Yeah, only a couple times a year.
Yeah, okay.
My hair's...
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I will shop in the medical department.
So, that needs a case and then there's a second case. All right. Yeah, there's state. We're ready to call two cases in this, right?
Okay.
That are on the calendar. We have two cases that are ready prior to the 1:30 case.
We're gonna do those now, or...
I don't think you might as well.
We need to get started.
Yeah, we'll start with those. They should be brief.
What we do.
Yep.
I am just happy to be here and hang out with you.
No, I usually guess.
My name is Lee. Should I have her come in?
But some animal.
I'll have her come in.
Clemens? I don't think so. I have no clue. I am a Lemming. I go where they ask me.
Smart man.
Representing the Elections Commission.
I always learn that things when I show up in court.
Becky?
Yeah, I know.
Unless you're doing it. You're just keeping it secret from me?
Yeah.
Your client.
Pens and new addresses are how it starts.
Antonequa Lee, 11CM5568, count 1, retail theft intentionally, 11CM6573, count 1, retail theft intentionally. A copy of criminal complaints, this is initial appearance. Both cases are assigned to Judge D, Branch 37. Needs to be booked. Appearances.
Tyler Renzo appears for the state.
Good afternoon, Your Honor. Attorney Frederick Clements appears on behalf of Antonequa Lee. Your Honor, her address now is 7667 North 99th Street, Apartment B. The zip code is 53224. Her phone number is 414-334-8799.
All right, good afternoon, counsel. Good afternoon, Ms. Lee. And counsel, did you receive copies of both complaints?
I did, Your Honor. I wrote formal reading and for pleas of not guilty in each count in each case. I am asking the court for one consideration if I could. I'd like to have her booked. She still needs to be booked either Monday or Tuesday next week. Frankly, I'm thinking if she goes in this afternoon, there's a good chance she could spend the entire weekend at the criminal justice facility. So we're hoping the court would permit her to have herself booked either Monday or Tuesday next week.
Yes, and the date would be, she would have between 5 o'clock today and 5 o'clock Tuesday.
Okay.
Anyway.
Right.
All right, so with that, Ms. Lee, these are very old cases, but it's still your initial appearance regarding the allegations in each complaint. You've been charged in each complaint with retail theft, one count in each complaint. They're both Class A misdemeanors. If you're convicted of either count, you could be fined not more than $10,000 or imprisoned for not more than 9 months or both. Do you understand those are the maximum penalties if you're convicted of either count as charged?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. I did review each complaint. Each complaint does state probable cause. You do have a right to counsel, and you are represented today. And today, counsel, what's her plea at this time?
Not guilty on each of the two counts in each case.
All right, and that'll be entered today. And what is the state's recommendation as to bail?
Thank you, Commissioner. The state's recommending, between the two cases, $1,000 PR bond. I think given the age of these cases, at Justice Point, monitoring might be appropriate or reminders. Thank you.
All right, counsel.
We don't have any objection to a PR bond, Your Honor. She did come in voluntarily to try to get all this cleared up. I would ask the court to make it a PR bond. I don't think, frankly, that Justice Point monitoring is necessary, but obviously that's up to the court.
All right, and thank you. And based on the type of allegations, Justice Point probably, she wouldn't fall into that risk category. It looks like these cases were issued on arrest warrants back in 2011, so both warrants have now been already cleared. So, Ms. Lee, I will set each case will be a $500 personal recognizance bond. That's a signature bond that you'll sign today. And also, as a condition of your bail, you do have to go through that booking process. So, again, it's going to be, you have to be booked between 5 o'clock today and 5 o'clock on Tuesday. Anytime in that time frame, the deputy will give you a little more information about that process.
But if you fail to be booked, then after Tuesday expires, then another warrant goes out for your arrest. Do you understand your bail?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and we're going to give you your next court date, which will be before the assigned judge.
We have the week of December 19th available, except the 23rd. Court hearing is December 20th at 1:30 before Judge D, Branch 37, Room 505 in the courthouse for a pretrial conference in person. I have a reminder slip.
She has to sign the PR
button. Yep. Yeah. Are there any
officership?
No.
I'm going to ask for a date either. In the next 2 weeks or in January?
Yeah,
month,
okay.
Is that okay?
Okay. 6 o'clock? Okay.
Six
o'clock.
All right.
Yeah.
It's up here.
Okay.
Yeah, you can get that all.
And we'll call that next.
Okay.
I'll give you a minute.
Okay. Cool.
Yeah, we're ready.
Okay.
You want to call Kimberly Zapata? The State of Wisconsin versus Kimberly Zapata, 22 CF 4307, count one, misconduct, office act, excessive authority, count 2, 3, 4, election fraud, absentee ballot. This case is assigned to Judge Corvello, Branch 36. This is the initial appearance. Counsel has received a copy of the criminal complaint. No bail has been posted. Appearances, please.
Matthew Westfall appears for the state. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Abigail Bongiorno especially appears for the defendant, Kimberly Zapata, and I would like to reserve all jurisdictional arguments.
All right, and counsel, did you receive a copy of the criminal complaint?
Yes, we did.
And do you waive its reading in court today?
Yes, Commissioner.
And good afternoon, Ms. Zapata. Today is your initial appearance regarding the allegations in the complaint. You've been charged in count one with misconduct in public office, act in excess of lawful authority, counts 2, 3, and 4 with false statement to obtain vote absentee ballot. Count one is the felony count. If you're convicted of that offense, it is a class I felony. You could be fined not more than $10,000 or imprisoned for not more than 3 years and 6 months or both. Counts 2, 3, and 4 are misdemeanors with the same penalty, and that would be a fine of not more than $1,000 or imprisoned for not more than 6 months or both. Do you understand those are the maximum penalties if you're convicted of any of the four counts? I did review the complaint. It does state probable cause. You do have a right to counsel, and you are represented today. As to the felony count, you do have a right to a preliminary hearing, and we'll set that date shortly. And counsel, what's her plea as to counts 2, 3, and 4?
Not guilty.
And that'll be entered today as to each of the misdemeanor counts. And what is the state's recommendation as to bail?
State would be recommending a personal recognizance bond. We'd be asking for a no contact order with Janelle Branchin and Claire Woodle Vogue. I did submit that order to the court earlier today. We'd also be asking for a condition that Ms. Zapata not be involved in the administration of any election-related matters during the pendency of this case.
All right, I missed the last part. What was no
involvement in the administration of any election-related matters during the pendency of this case.
All right, thank you. And counsel, as to bail?
We have no issue with a personal recognizance bond in regards to no contact with Jeanette Claire. That is actually a personal friend of the defendant as well. And they do discuss things that are not work-related. I don't see why they would have no contact.
All right, does the state wish to respond?
Director Woodle-Vogue is a witness in this case, such that there are always concerns of potential undue influence being put by defendants on witnesses. I think it's appropriate.
All right, thank you. All right, Ms. Zapata, I did review the allegations. I did note that there's no prior criminal convictions. You do appear today with counsel, so a personal recognizance bond is appropriate. So I am going to set your bail in this case at a $2,500 personal recognizance bond. That's a signature bond that you'll sign today. Also, as a condition of your bail, you are not to take part in any administrative election proceedings or related to elections during the pendency of this case. Do you understand that condition? Understand, and I guess any administration of election-related matters, to be more precise. Do you understand that condition?
Yes, she's still technically employed with the Election Commission, but she will not be actively participating in any employment.
All right, and that's during the pendency of this case or until a judge were to change that condition. All right, I am going to sign the no contact order as it's written today, since this is your first appearance, and the state's indicated that the people outlined on the no contact order are witnesses. So that is Janelle, Brangen, and Claire Woodall Volk. So no contact means no contact in person by any third party, by mail, phone, or any other electronic device. And you'll get a copy of the no contact order. And then again, going forward, only the judge can modify that no contact order. Do you understand your bail, Ms. Zapata? All right, we're going to set your next court date, which will be your preliminary hearing.
For scheduling purposes, I'm out of the office the last 2 weeks of this month, so either before then or after then would be the state's request.
Would this be an in-person?
It can be by Zoom, and we'll give you that information for the prelim.
Perfect.
The next court day will be December 9th at 1:30 for the preliminary hearing and prelim court before Commissioner Phillips. And that can be in person.
Thank you very much.
All right, thank you.
And you may step by the deputy.
You have to step by the deputy to sign your PR bond.
Just my card.
Thank you very much.